Today I want to speak about one of my favorite bands of doom death metal from England, and I'm speaking about Anathema. But I'm speaking about the old Anathema. In the 90s we had many bands that they started as metal bands, and afterwards they became something different, something totally different. Let's remember Tiamat from Sweden, or Paradise Lost for Elite, for two albums they became something else, or In Flames, Enslaved, or Ulver. They changed their style totally. Catatonia, of course. So Anathema is one of these bands that changed their style totally. After their fourth album, they became even more even less metal. There are some people that will say that also in their fifth album, Judgment, in 1999, they played a little bit metal, but for me it's a little bit more progressive rock, influenced by Pink Floyd and even more from Radiohead. So for me, Judgment, their fifth album, is not metal. Some people maybe will say that this is also the last metal album of them. And so here I will speak only about their works until Judgment. I will not speak about Judgment and the other albums that came afterwards. They made 11 albums, 11 studio albums. For example, Judgment in 1999, afterwards the sixth album, A Fine Day to Exit, 2001, the seventh album, A Natural Disaster, 2003, the eighth album, We Are Here Because We Are Here, in 2010, also the sister of their first drummer and keyboardist, Lee Douglas, became their vocalist in these days. The ninth album, Wither Systems, in 2012, and Distant Satellites, their 10th album, 2014, and their last album, their 11th album, The Optimist, 2017, and afterwards they split up. So today we don't have even progressive rock Anathema. But here we'll speak about the first period of the band, when they were doom death metal band. They started in 1990 in Liverpool, and their first name of the band was Pagan Angel. Afterwards they changed the name to Anathema. In the beginning there were three brothers, the brothers Kavanagh, Vincent, Daniel, and Jamse. Jamse played the bass, but he left after a little bit period of time. Also, they had John Douglas as their drummer and keyboardist. And their first singer was Darren White, and he was he had very good growls, let's say like that. Their first demo came out in 1990 by the name An Iliad of Woes. Their second demo, All Faith is Lost, in 1991. And afterwards they made a deal with Peaceville Records, and they made their first EP in 1992 by the name The Crest Fallen. Afterwards came their first album, studio album of 1993, Serenades, and a little bit afterwards their second EP, Pentecost 3, in 1994, but came out in 1995. In this period of time, Darren White, their first singer, left the band in 1995 and he made another band by the name The Blood Divine. In these years, Vincent, the guitarist, Kavanagh became their singer. He had even more clean vocals and a little bit more harsh vocals in the beginning. And they made their second album, The Silent Enigma, in 1995. Their third album came out in 1996 by the name Eternity. John Douglas, their drummer and keyboardist, left in 1997. So they took also some members of My Dying Bride, also of Cradle of Filth, bands from England also. And in 1998, they made their fourth album, Alternative 4. So, afterwards, we have their fifth album, Judgment, 1999. And let's say that from this time and afterwards, they cut every connection with metal. So, here I will speak about their first works, about their four studio albums, and their first two EPs. In my, of course, personal opinion. So, and I hear maybe some people will not agree with me, but in the fifth place, I will put their fourth, and for me, last metal album, Alternative 4, that came out in 1998. This album, I don't know, many people believe that this is the best Anathema album, but for, I don't have the connection with this album. It's a very bit, it's very melancholic, very progressive. Okay, in the next album, Judgment, they became even more progressive and Pink Floyd progressive influences. And here also we have these influences, but I don't know why I'm not connected with this album. Also, this is their fourth album, it's the last album with the original logo of them. In the fourth place for me comes their third album of 1996, Eternity, and this was the first album of Anathema that I listened, also very melancholic. Also very with clean vocals and also very very special, but also this is a melodic and melancholic but a metal album. In the third place, their first album, the most harsh album of them, of 1993, Serenades. Darren White was the singer in this album, a great doom death metal album. In the second place, I will put here their two EPs. The Crestfallen EP, their first EP of 1992, and Pentecost 3 of 1994-95, their second EP. I prefer a little bit more The Crestfallen of 1992, but it's a great, great, great also a combination of the two first EPs of them. Also, Dan White was the singer here. But in the first place, the best album of Anathema and one of my favorite albums of metal of all time and of the 90s, their second album of 1995, The Silent Enigma, a great, great album. Also, the first song of this album, Restless Oblivion, is one of the best songs of doom, death, gothic metal. Here we can also listen gothic rock and gothic metal influences. Vincent, first of, he is the first time that he's the singer of the band. A great, great, great album. For me, not only is the best Anathema, also is one of the best albums of the 90s and one of the best metal albums of all time. the silent enigma of anathema. So, from Israel, from Jerusalem, stay metal and stay heavy.